My name is Vishnu Gopal TV. I am a legal intern at Lexis & Company. I am from Cooperative School of Law, Kerala. I am a third year student pursuing BBA LLB honors. So, today's topic for this video is types of offer. So, the purpose of this video is to analyze different types of offer under the Indian Contract Act. So, as we know, Section 2 Clause A of the Indian Contract Act defines the term offer. So, Section 2 Clause A states that when one person signifies to another his willingness to do or abstain from doing anything with a view to obtaining the assent of that other, such act or abstinence, he is said to make a proposal. So, we know that these offers are of different types. So, there are express offer, or there are express offer, implied offer, cross offer, counter offer, specific offer, general offer, and standing offer. So, here there is a need to look into different types of offer to understand each type of offer and its concept in a detailed manner. So, first, there is a need to look into the concept of express offer and implied offer. So, express offers are those offers which are made in words, spoken or written. It is an offer which gives to another, and the thing that has to be noted here is that such an offer can be made or can be either given in words spoken or in written words. So, hence, this is known as express offer. So, for example, if a person says to another that will you purchase my apartment at Kannur for 10 lakh rupees? So, this is an express offer. So, implied offer means the offers which are made neither in words spoken or in written. Here, the offer is made in an implied manner. So, that is implied offer. So, now the concept of specific offer and general offer has to be also analyzed. Specific offer means offers which are made to a specific person and not to the world at large. Here, the offer is given to a particular person or a specific person. On the other hand, general offer, it's not like that. General offer means offers which are made to the public or world at large is said to be known as general offer. One of the important cases that has to be analyzed here is Bhajan Lal versus Charan Lal. It's a case of 1925. Here, in Bhajan Lal versus Charan Lal, a young boy ran away from his father's house. Father issued a pamphlet which is offering rupees 500 for the person who finds that boy. So the plaintiff found that boy and brought him to the railway police station, and after that he made a call to the father. So, but the father refused to pay the money as per mentioned in the pamphlet which has been issued. So, here the court clearly held that the defendant had made a general offer which is open to the whole world and anyone could accept it by fulfilling the conditions. The plaintiff, by fulfilling the condition here, and is now entitled to get the offered amount. So, cross offer and counter offer has to be also looked into. Cross offer means when two persons are making identical offers to each other without knowing each other's offer, then it is known as cross offer. So, we had looked into the concept of cross offer. So, now we can look into counter offer. So, counter offer means without accepting the offer made by the offerer, he desires modification of the same. So, that's about counter offer. So, now there is a need to look into the concept of standing offer. So, what is meant by this term standing offer? It means an offer which is continuously enforceable for a certain period of time. So, therefore, we have analyzed in detail manner regarding the concept of offer, types of offer, that is such as express offer, implied offer, cross offer, counter offer, specific offer, general offer, and standing offer. So, that's all about the topic. So you can like, subscribe and comment on my video, and do like and subscribe our YouTube channel Let's Click. Please give me a feedback regarding this video, and if you have any questions relating to this video, you may please mention that question in the comment box and I will be replying as soon as possible. This video does not solicit any types of promotion or advertisement as per the guidelines of Bar Council of India, and the sole purpose of this video is for educational purposes only. So by saying these words, I'm concluding. Thank you.